And we can actually talk about that now because I'm going to tell you about a study. Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. I'm talking PRF versus PRP. I wanted to bring this up because everyone asks on YouTube, every conference I go to, and on Instagram. If you haven't been over to our Instagram, pop over at RajaniMD Skincare. We have great topics on all these issues over there and a lot of before and afters. So everyone wants proof. PRF versus PRP. A little bit about them I'm going to tell you, and then I'm going to talk about the study. First of all, platelet-rich plasma was the original blood product. The next generation, they call it, is platelet-rich fibrin. Why? Everyone wants that golden, beautiful serum, basically, of PRP, and they want to inject a lot of it in the face. Keep in mind, it's platelet-rich plasma we want, not platelet-poor plasma. That's the first thing. The other thing is PRF is used around the world, but part of the problem is there's no blood thinner in it, no sodium citrate or heparin, and that's actually what makes it work, but the problem is it can then clot, so you have to inject the liquid form, and that's what's very particular about making it up. And if you see my YouTube videos, everyone asks, how do you prepare it? And I'll put a link down below for that in the description. PRF, the goodness with platelets, it forms a three-dimensional fiber clot after it goes in because there's no blood thinner. There's white cells in the milieu, which have been shown to be important. It's a slow spin speed, and there's often twice the platelet count for those people that want to compare the number of platelet count, and the growth factors are found around the platelets. That's why it's important. Now, a lot more on that, but you'll find more information on the links I put in the description. Why are we here today? Because the first study that I know of that puts platelet-rich plasma against platelet-rich fibrin was recently done in China, and it was published in Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery Journal just recently, and it was done with rabbits, and they took fat from the groin region, they harvested, they spun it, and they add PRP to one group and PRF to another group, put it back in the ear like we might do with fat transfer, although usually we put it in the buttock or other areas, but in this case, they put it in the ear because it was measurable and they looked at the differences. Now you may say, well, it's in a rabbit and different things, but most of the other studies, a lot of them are in vivo. They're not even in living subjects. So this is a benefit to us. It's not just in a test tube, but this is in a living animal. And what it showed was there was no increase in fat per se, but there was a definite increase in blood flow, or what we call neovascularization, in the PRF group. So that, and you can read the entire study, I don't want to bore you with all of it, but it showed PRF to be superior to the PRP. And so very interesting first study. Of course, many more studies need to be done. And before everyone comments, we know we're in the infancy of learning all these, and so there's not a lot of studies out there. The dentists and the orthopedists have papers on them, and so you can look those up. But what I tell people, because everyone wants to know, should I buy a PRP, should I buy a PRF? What I did, we had seven different systems here. You can buy two, it's your patients, and doing the best for your patients is ultimately important. And if you're not sure, a lot of people already have PRP, it's not that expensive to have a PRF system in your practice, and you can compare both side by side, which is what we did. We're almost at 4,000 patients with platelet-rich fibrin now. So that's a lot of data, a lot of experience, and so I'm very, very comfortable with it. It is a little trickier to prepare. You have a short time to inject it because we're not using the clot. We inject a liquid that forms a clot. I'll put a link to the study also in the description for those readers out there who want to know more about it. And we're also going to do something over on our Instagram page as well. So there you have it. Everyone asked me PRP versus PRF. It goes on your experience and the experience of your key opinion leaders around the country and around the world. A lot of in vivo studies, and now we're getting, a lot of in vitro studies in the test tube studies, and now we're getting more in vivo or in life studies. So those are coming. But we're in the infancy of this game, and blood products are an amazing source to rejuvenate your skin, join me over on Instagram, join me here, let us know what your experience is below in the YouTube comments, and subscribe here for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.